This one is gonna be a really simple, easy summer look with a bright lip. I really wanna say thank you to Kathy. I hope I pronounce your name all right. I really apologize if I didn't. I wanna thank you for leaving me your comment for the idea for this video. And I was so excited because this makeup look is really one of my most favorite makeup looks, and I don't know how it didn't came to my mind earlier. Now, first off, a simple, but I still need to use a primer, and I'm gonna use the Essence Mattifying Primer just because my skin is really oily in the T-zone, I mean. So I mainly, you know, try to focus on the here. I'm gonna use a mixture of these two foundations, Fit Me from Maybelline and a little bit from the Catrice Liquid Coverage. I've noticed on myself, you see I have this new pigmentation spots here, and I've noticed that when I'm trying to wear a bright lip, I really need to even out my skin tone one step further than if I go for like a nude lip or something. And as much as I want to use a lighter consistency foundation for myself, I mean, with these marks and stuff, it doesn't really, I don't like the way it looks. Now I'm gonna give it just a minute to, maybe like a few seconds, just to set a bit more. And I'm gonna go in with my Born to Glow concealer from NYX, and mine is in the shade Soft Beige. Just gonna cover up my scars here, and this is funny, you see, I finally see the darkness. Like, I mean, after the surgery, I noticed I have dark circles under my eyes. I just couldn't see them before. Okay, the concealer is done, and I'm gonna go back into the foundation for the tiniest bit more coverage here in this area only. But honestly, guys, this is the only extra in this makeup look. I mean, the fact that I'm doing a bit more coverage, all the rest is the easiest makeup ever. I'm gonna use the I'm gonna use the Rimmel powder. This one is in the shade Sandstorm 004, and I'm just gonna set my face. Now, obviously, if you wanna go for a bit more glowy makeup and you don't have oily skin like mine, you just can skip the powder. Just to make sure I don't have any creasing concealer under my eyes, even though this concealer doesn't really tend to crease. Now for the eyebrows, I'm gonna use the Maybelline Brow Ultra Slim. This time I'm gonna use, yeah, it's medium brown. This is medium brown, and I'm just gonna fill in my brows a bit. A bit of brow gel, NYX Control Freak. You've seen this, I think, a million times. Can you please focus on me? Just the tiniest bit for a bit of shape. So I was just explaining how I'm using this liner and when I'm using it, and then I realized that I didn't press the record button. So I was talking to myself. Anyway, I was just saying that you've obviously seen that I did already the line. I'm using the same pencil from We Makeup Italy, the brown one. It doesn't matter which one. Now, if it's a special occasion, and if I want to be a bit more kind of like one step a bit smarter, then, you know, you get what I'm saying, probably. I will go for a black classic liner, like an eyeliner. A baby wing, probably, but most of the times I'm gonna go for something brown, something like espresso brown, dark brown. But the main difference here is you can see that I just lined my upper lids, but I don't want to wing out the liner like before. Because the thing with the bright lips for me personally is, if I'm gonna do a bright lip, I want to keep the things on the situation on my eyes as simple as possible. The focus I want to be on my lips and not on my eyes, if that makes sense. So I'm just lining my lash line for a bit of a definition. I will smudge it, and then I might do like a pearly shade a bit in the center, something in the center for a bit of pop, and a bit of something to contour my eyes, you know, just to bring back the shape here, just so it doesn't look so plain, completely plain. And I'm just gonna use the same small brush from Morphe, M213. Now, this small makeup eyeshadow palette, sorry, from Wet n Wild, which is in the shade, the name of the palette is My Glamour Squad, I think. These eyeshadows are just amazing, so affordable, and so versatile colors. Just look at that, so many things you can do with this small palette. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna try to blend the edges of this brown shade with this kind of like, it's something like a medium brown. So I'm just gonna mix a bit of this with a bit of this, and on a small blending brush I'll tap all over the on top of the brown, if that makes sense. First of all, to set it, otherwise it might start to smudge, you know, during the day or transfer. And to soften the color a bit, because I went a bit overboard with the line. It's just thicker than necessary. Now I'm patting the color on my mobile lid as well, a bit. And I think I start to get back some shape. Now with just a fluffier brush, I'm gonna take from the same color, which is the lighter shade, this one. I'm just gonna apply the tiniest bit here, you know, in this area, just to, like I told you, to bring back the contour of my eyelid. But this is so, so subtle. It's like almost invisible. Now, honestly, I think this is completely enough with the brown. And I'm gonna use the tiniest bit of this kind of like champagne-y, like a champagne-y gold shade, kind of like a highlighter shade. And I'm just gonna tap that in the center of my lid, just here. Just for really, really the tiniest bit of pop. And if I decide sometimes, you know, depending from the situation, I might go back to like a brown, like this shade, which is really similar to the pencil, actually. And I might go in the really, really roots of my lashes, just here. Just because the shimmery shade kind of like covered the brown a bit, but not fully. So this will give it like a bit of gradient. I'm just gonna highlight my brow bone. Now, lastly, for the tiniest bit more definition, I will try to apply the same mixture of browns, you know, the lighter and the darker, on my lower lash line. The thing is, when I start applying eyeshadow on my lower lash line, I always want to go for an eyeliner in the waterline. And right now, because my eyes are sensitive and they're watering a lot after the surgery, it doesn't really help. So I'm just gonna try to really keep this in the outer corner only as much as possible, so I don't feel the need all of a sudden to put anything in my waterline. Of course, curling my lashes, I'll do some mascara off camera so you don't sit and wait for me here. I will use the Lash Princess from Essence. Now you can do lashes, I won't. This time I will use the medium matte bronzer from NYX. This one I can use now, this medium shade from NYX. But just summertime when I get a bit more tanned, otherwise it really tends to pull a red on me. I'll always do a bit of bronzer on my nose. I'll definitely go for the double chin a bit, you know. Now today I'm gonna use H&M blush. I don't know if they still do this. It's a shade coral, and I will try to keep it this way so you can see the, it's really corally shaped. Just because I'm gonna use a warmer bright lip this time, a bit more orangey one. If I was to use a bit more bluish, like a bit more cool tone pink or a red, like a cool tone, a reddish shade kind of on my lips, I would go for a bit more pinkish blush, if this makes sense. And I'm always doing my blush kind of like, I mean, it almost matches the place where I do highlighter. And I'm doing this, my temples always. But it's like always up here, just so I can give some lift to my face. And I think that's totally enough. Then for the highlighter, I chose Wet n Wild again, just because I love this thing. After Sex Glow is the name, blush lighter. And now this time, I'm just gonna use a bit more of the pinkish, peachy shade, using the same brush, which I use. And I'm gonna try to top my blush kind of like here, and the tiniest bit of the gold shade exclusively on the really, really high points of my cheeks, just here, you see, really high up. And from the gold shade, I'm just adding a bit on my nose. I know that not everyone likes to do this, but I like it, so I'm just doing it. If you don't like highlighter on your nose, just, you know, don't do it. I just overdid it now here and I need to get rid of some of it. And then we have the lips and we are completely done. Now I'm gonna use this orangey lip pencil from Zina, is the name of this. I think this is a new, I'm not sure if it's Greek company, really, I don't know. They recently, you know, launched here in Cyprus and I'm not familiar with the brand, but I, you know, got the lip pencil and I think I used it once, twice. I really liked it, so, but any orangey lip liner, or I mean, like, just so you don't get your lipstick kind of like fading into any lines if you have, like I do on my lips. So you can obviously see that I line all of my lips with a pencil. I always do that when I'm using a bright lip, just so I can get the lip to stay, you know, like the color to stay as long as possible, because I'm not gonna use a liquid lip. I'm just gonna use a standard creamy lipstick, and even I will show you the one which I'll use. Many times I will go for MAC Lady Danger, which is quite more orange than this one. This one today is Bourjois. This is the French brand, and the shade is 29. This is how the color looks like. I think it looks a bit more lighter there. I will just pull it here. Most of my favorite corally bright lipsticks are actually creamy lipsticks. So I will always do the liner first, full, and then I will do one layer of the lipstick. I will pat with a napkin, and then I'll do a second layer with the lipstick, just so I can make sure it stays on my lips as long as possible. Okay, so I have one layer done. I'm just gonna pat it. So like now it's gonna turn a bit more like a stain. And then I'm gonna go with the lipstick again. And voila, guys. Now the only thing I will do is I'll do a bit of setting spray. Obviously I'm gonna do mattifying setting spray. I'm gonna use the same one I used last time, NYX Matte Finish. I just need to finish this bottle. If you have a bit more dry skin, you can always go for a bit more like a dewy skin mist, something. I just really, really find something mesmerizing in this kind of bright lip. Let me know down in the comments what you think. And I really hope the bright lips do the same to you like to me. I mean, they just brighten up my mood as well. I hope that was helpful and inspiring at least. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye for now.